After the Supreme Court order, private labs are now testing for coronavirus for free. How are they making this feasible with no government guidelines or subsidies on this so far? I speak to the co-founder of Meddo to find out.
In terms of what's needed from the government, I think this entire financial process of who pays for the tests, how much do they pay for the test, what test and what process exactly is to be followed, and by when do we get the payment. I think those are the key elements of the financial transaction that are not clear. There is a ruling which enables or which mandates the test to be given for free, but the financial burden of that test cannot be taken purely by the private players, right? So I think the government needs to quickly, over the next couple of days maybe, quickly help us through ironing out the process around payments and around how do we do the reporting, right? So what basis do we get paid on? Is that a cash payment, or is this going to be paid in terms of kits, both PPE kits as well as testing kits? As the infection widens, is there a rapid testing that we are allowed through the private tests or the private testing labs as well or not? Because currently we can only do the RT-PCR testing, and the rapid card test still is a much, I would say, faster way of testing, but it's not open to the private labs yet. So I think those would be the two broad areas of help that we would seek from the government. The government has given clear guidelines around testing procedure. I think, for you to be able to get tested, you need a prescription from a registered medical practitioner. And they've also, prescribed the format that the prescription needs to be, or at least the key elements that the prescription needs to necessarily carry. So it needs to have doctor's name, doctor's medical registration number, the medical council with which the doctor is registered, and it has to be signed and stamped by the doctor as well, right? So these are the important key elements for the prescription. Along with that, you need a form 44 and your ID that is needed for you to be able to go through the test. In terms of the test itself, like I mentioned, it's a RT-PCR test. So we take a nasal and a throat swab. And once the test is done, it's done by a specific medical personnel, which do it in a completely covered gear. It's called the personal protection equipment, PPE kit, that they use while taking the sample. And once the sample is taken, you get reports mostly between 48 to 72 hours. Well, as you know, the Supreme Court has now come out with an interim order directing the government to enable all the private labs also to provide coronavirus testing for free. So currently, we are not enabled to do the rapid card testing. So we are doing what you call the longer process of RT-PCR testing, which happens through a nasal and a throat swab. So for that, I think from a medical perspective, that's a perfectly right decision. That's what we do need as a country, to kind of widen the base of testing, detect cases early, and try and quarantine as much as possible. So while from medical perspective, I think that's a fantastic step, you're absolutely right. There is a part of financial liability that comes through. Currently, we are trying to subsidize and optimize the costs as much. And whatever is the cost burden is currently being borne by the Meddo Foundation. That's our nonprofit arm, where we work with different parties to kind of tide through this entire ensuing period. Our partner labs, which are the ICMR approved labs, are also helping us kind of bring down the costs as much as possible. So between these two, I think we're still able to manage the costs right now. But honestly, that's not a sustainable answer, right? So while we are kind of covering it for the time period that there is clear guidelines around the costing and around the payment terms, I think it's not something that can go on for perpetuity. So we need more defined answers around that for sure. If you want to get tested through Meddo, then you simply need to log on to our website, which is www.meddo.in, meddo.in, and you will see the direct link to the corona test booking page. There you need to upload the two important documents. Document number one is your prescription from or a valid prescription from a registered medical practitioner. I've just talked about the key elements that the prescription should contain. And the second important document is your government issued ID. So if you have these two, then we kind of take the test booking, and the team gets back in touch with you to get the form 44 and a few other documents done. Also, what's the precise time for pickup, place for pickup, et cetera, is kind of sorted by the team once we get in the request. Just one more point of mention, we are currently only offering this in Delhi NCR. We're based out of Delhi NCR. We'll launch other cities soon, but as of now, we're only doing this in Delhi NCR. And second, like I said, it's important to have a valid prescription, clearly mentioning a COVID-19 test from a registered medical practitioner. That's it.
So even though Meddo is a relatively new startup, they are still being able to roll out free testing and sustain it. But they're saying that it's not going to be sustainable for long without government help. So in the future, we could see the number of tests being done going down if private labs decide that they cannot do free testing and decide to stop testing altogether. We are still looking forward to getting some government guidelines or some announcements about subsidies on this in the coming days. This is Suryatapa Mukherjee for Mojo.